Recently, I've been itching to build something with C, both to improve my skills with the language, but also to actually just make a project. I knew I wanted to make something terminal focused because I wanted to play around with making ANSI codes for coloring terminal text. I also wanted to work with images in C. I do have some experience with computer vision stuff, but not really in a low-level context. I decided to write a little project that would take in an image and then print it out to the terminal using ASCII characters and terminal colors. We've also got a little secret sauce going on to highlight the edges of the image. In order to print an image, you first need to load it in from storage. I initially wanted to write my own bitmap parser, which would have been simple enough, but I wanted this to work for any file type, and parsing JPEG and PNG files seemed a little bit trickier. After some digging, I found this library called stbimage that looked really simple to use. I also appreciated that it was all in a single header file, so setting it up was as simple as downloading the file and then writing an include statement. So, how does it work? Loading an image amounts to getting the metadata, like the width and height of the image, as well as the number of channels it has, so for example red, green, blue, and then allocating an array for each of the pixel channel values. Note that the image data is stored as an array of unsigned characters. The array is made by flattening the image and then splitting out each channel. We use unsigned characters because it's one byte per value and each value is between 0 and 255. Next, we have to resize the image. This is because we want to render the image in the terminal, and if your terminal is only 100 characters or so wide, we don't want it to start wrapping around. We also need to be careful because characters in the terminal usually have height to width ratios of around 2 to 1. And so we also need to shrink the image in height so that when we print out each pixel, the character stretches it back out. There are a few different ways to shrink the image. The smoothest option is to average over all the pixel values in a given region and then use that value as the new pixel. Finally, we can actually print the image to the screen. If a pixel in the image is brighter, we're going to use a more full ASCII character. While this works and looks great for some images, it's quite hard to see what's going on for others. An easy fix here is to add extra contrast with colors. We can add colors to our terminal text by using ANSI escape sequences. These are pretty neat and pretty simple to use. By just printing out a special keyword, the terminal will know to interpret that in a certain way. The simplest example is \n, which tells the terminal to move the cursor to the next line. Conveniently, there's a set of these which we can use to change the color of the text, and they're quite well supported. How do we decide what color to use for each pixel? I do this by converting the pixel RGB values into HSV, which stands for hue, saturation, and value. To understand what's going on here, let's talk about visualizing color space. A single pixel has three values, red, green, and blue. We can think of this as a vector in 3D. And since each channel value is constrained between 0 and 1, all the possible colors we can make fall into a cube. Now look at what happens when we look at this cube from one of its corner. You can see that we get the color wheel, or in this case more of a color hexagon. But by transforming this cube, we can turn it into a cylinder. Specifically, this is the HSV cylinder. The polar coordinate gives the hue, the radial coordinate gives the saturation, and the axial component gives the value. It's pretty straightforward then to decide what color we want each pixel to print as. We use the value to determine what character gets assigned to a given pixel. Now turning to the saturation, if the saturation is low, the pixel is close to being on the grayscale, and so we can just make that pixel white. If the saturation is high, the pixel is more colorful, so if it's in the red region, we'll round it to red, if it's in the yellow region, we round it to yellow, etc. And so now the outputs from these are way better, but are still missing something very important. A key feature of ASCII art is that it highlights edges by using the underscore, slashes, and vertical bar. So we need to be able to not just detect edges, but also what direction they face. The obvious choice here is Sobel edge detection. There are two Sobel kernels, one for the X direction and one for the Y. Running a convolution of these kernels with our image gives us a scaled approximation of the gradient. And the gradient is just a vector that points in the direction of steepest ascent. So when the gradient is large, the pixel values change sharply, and so there must be an edge there. We can get the direction of the edge by looking at the angle of the gradient. All in all, I'm pretty happy with the results. This was a really fun project. It was nice to get some experience with C. And if you want to play around with this, all of the code is on GitHub. Please feel free to check it out, or feel free to add anything if you have any suggestions.